Tonight, coronavirus declared a global health emergency, the push to ban every flight from China.
Detectives investigating a terrifying armed sexual assault on a woman in Rafford Creek.
Ken Vowles resigns from Parliament, sparking the Johnston by-election.
This is Nine News Darwin.
Good evening. The coronavirus outbreak is now officially a global health emergency as the death toll surges past 200.
A second person now has the virus in Queensland, a woman on the same Tiger flight as the first confirmed case. Authorities now contacting hundreds of passengers from subsequent flights on the same plane.
One of the 172 people on board the contaminated Tiger Air flight, a mother in a mask, arrives at hospital after phoning Queensland's health hotline.
She said that a lot of GPs actually weren't actually testing. They're supposed to, but they're refusing to do it.
A 42-year-old Chinese woman on flight TT566 is Queensland's second case of the virus.
Before Tiger Air was notified of the situation, the same plane made up to a dozen more flights before it was promptly sterilised. Although the risk is low, health authorities can't guarantee more people haven't been infected.
The danger is going to be absolutely minimal. I can't say it's zero because we don't have that full information.
A Qantas 747 is ready to evacuate Australians from Wuhan. 50 cabin crew have volunteered for the mission, way more than needed. Beyond China, the virus has spread to 22 countries. Enough, the World Health Organization says, to officially declare a global emergency. The sixth time the call has been made.
The main reason for this declaration is not because of what is happening in China, but because of what is happening in other countries.
50 flights from China pour passengers into Australian airports every day, where workers are now threatening to walk off the job if they're not provided proper protective equipment.
The reality is no airport screening, no flights. We don't want it to get to that point.
In Queensland, Chinese community leaders are being briefed daily amid reports some taxi drivers are refusing to pick up passengers wearing masks. Uncertainty spreading all the way to the top. The Premier lashing the federal government over its handling of the virus threat.
We do not know in Queensland where people are who have come from Hubei province in the last 14 days and where they are staying.
There would not be an issue that the Commonwealth knows that the Queensland government does not know.
A sense of hope in the haze. The CSIRO could be ready to test a vaccine on humans in 16 weeks.
So we're taking that on board as a great challenge.
Rob Morrison, Nine News.
And Nine's Gary Adshead is in Christmas Island tonight, where the government is coming close to pulling the trigger on this evacuation.
Yes, we understand that tonight at 8 o'clock a Border Force flight will arrive here at Christmas Island in readiness for the detention centre opening up for the Wuhan evacuees. The people on Christmas Island have got very mixed feelings about it still. The Christmas Island Tourism Association person has told us that they're very concerned about the damage it's doing to the image of Christmas Island once again as it tries to get its tourism industry up and running. Now, there are people who are working out at the detention centre at the moment who are also concerned because they're contractors and they're very concerned about their own health and how this is going to play out, and quite frankly not being told much, as we understand it, about the plan that the federal government is putting in place in readiness now for the arrival of these evacuees once the Qantas flight has left Wuhan.
Detectives are tonight calling for witnesses to come forward after a man sexually assaulted a woman in Rapid Creek. As Nine's Ellie Conway reports, the woman was threatened with a knife.
It's a popular recreational path used by walkers and cyclists in the northern suburbs, but early this morning, police received a report of an assault. A 32-year-old woman was riding her bike along the path at 5 o'clock this morning when police say she was approached by a man
who pulled her to the ground and threatened her with a knife before sexually assaulting her.
A bystander intervened and the man ran off towards the Rapid Creek footbridge.
The alleged offender is described as of Indigenous appearance, 25 to 30 years old, about 170 centimetres tall.
He was wearing a blue sports singlet and dark shorts. Investigators say the woman wasn't physically harmed and the bystander disappeared before they arrived.
We are not sure who that man is and police would very much like to speak to him.
Detectives are urging anyone with further information to come forward.
A police officer and a paramedic have undergone testing after a 25-year-old man allegedly spat blood into their faces and assaulted them while they were driving him to Royal Darwin Hospital.
That period of waiting just to find out whether you've been impacted by that in relation to the blood-borne diseases, etc., is quite distressing.
The man's been arrested and police say charges will be laid.
It's been a long, drawn-out wait, but finally retiring member for Johnston, Ken Vowles, has handed in his resignation, this kick-starting what's sure to be a closely watched contest.
Returning from holidays, Ken Vowles is now ready to start his new chapter.
A bit nervous, disappointed, but also a little bit excited as well.
Making his final media rounds today before handing in his resignation at Parliament House this afternoon. Yeah. The move officially triggering the by-election for Johnston, which covers the suburbs of Milner, Jingalee, Moyle and Alloa. While he says Labor's Joel Bowden is the likely favourite, he does think it could be anyone's to win. But according to Mr Vowles, Labor still needs to ditch Michael Gunner to retain government in August, especially after the change with the CLP.
People have switched off to Michael, they've switched off to Nicole, they're listening to Natasha, and we need to find somebody else, and that's why I suggested Selena.
But Natasha Files has refused to answer if she has ambitions of ever becoming Chief Minister.
I'm not going to talk about hypotheticals. It's a big year for Territorians.
As for Mr Gunner, he returns from sick leave on Monday. We're focused on delivering our plan for more jobs, not more CLP cuts. It will be a choice between jobs or cuts.
And so it officially begins. Expect the election campaign for Johnston to really heat up with just 23 days until polling day on February 29.
Kathleen Gazzola, Nine News.
An NT police officer accused of assaulting three people while on duty has defended his actions on the witness stand during his final hearing day. Nine's Zarisha Bradley has been in court.
Body-worn police vision of the incident was played to the head officer of operational safety today. He told the court the accused officer used unnecessary force towards two women. 34-year-old Raymond Nielsen Scott is accused of pushing over a woman who has since died of unrelated causes and cannot be named for legal reasons, as well as her mother, Wendy Lalara, and father, Solomon Mamarica. Mr Nielsen Scott was responding to a call out that Mr Mamarica was armed with a knife in Berrima and trying to stab his daughter. He said he pushed the daughter because she spat in his face and was yelling and screaming, prompting a response from her parents. But operational safety officer Andrew Barham couldn't see any physical threat she posed to Mr Nielsen Scott. He agreed she was talking loudly, but she was just threatened with a knife. Judge Elizabeth Armitage will now decide the verdict.
Let's take a look at the price of fuel in Darwin. Unleaded is averaging $1.38 per litre.
An accused triple murderer will be released back into the community after a successful bid for bail. Bruce John Preston was arrested last year over the shooting deaths of three people in outback Queensland more than 40 years ago.
He was arrested last April, 40 years after the outback shooting murders of Karen Edwards, Tim Thompson and Gordon Twaddle in Mount Isa in 1978. Their accused killer, 64-year-old former prison officer Bruce John Preston, granted conditional bail on his second bid.
When released, Preston will be allowed to live in his home at Goulburn, New South Wales, but he'll have to surrender his passport and report regularly to police. He'll also have to hand over three guns registered to him. The court heard he's a keen licensed hunter.
The court also heard Preston was convicted of possessing one of his alleged victim's motorbikes after the man's death. Justice Peter Davis telling the court Bruce Preston poses no risk of re-offending and has cooperated with police. Ebony Cavallaro, Nine News.
Now to a major breakthrough in the investigation into the suspected murder of toddler Connor Horan. Crime scenes are being searched across Warwick, southwest of Brisbane, after an anonymous caller gave detectives critical information.
A tearful plea from a heartbroken mother.
It's been a nightmare. We really, really need to get to the bottom of this.
Still searching for answers 18 months after losing her beloved son, Connor Horan. Just days after this interview, an anonymous call through Crime Stoppers delivers a major breakthrough.
The information provided is very significant and will help us with our investigation.
So significant, police established three crime scenes across Warwick today.
This is the home where Connor's babysitter claims that he suffered fatal injuries falling down a small set of stairs. Now it's a crime scene. Detectives combing the property for evidence.
Her current home and car, the two other areas of interest, as this babysitter remains the prime suspect in this case. Detectives now want to speak to that anonymous caller from Crime Stoppers, believing they could help police convict Connor's killer.
That person could come forward to the Warwick Police Station. The detective's here to speak to you basically 24/7 with that information you provide via Crime Stoppers.
As well as anyone else who has any information that can help deliver justice to Connor's grieving family. Sophie Upcroft, Nine News.
A monster fire threat closing in on Canberra.
Optus in trouble. Wyatt's paying $500,000 in fines.
Plus, Prince Harry's fight with a British tabloid ends, but who won?
They're the hottest young guns in the world. The future of tennis.
Incredible!
Next, Zverev and team in a blockbuster semi-final.
Magnificent.
Who will take on Djokovic in the epic decider? The unmissable second semi-final. Zverev team, next on Nine.
Bonus! 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 It's a computer bonus bonanza at Joyce Main Darwin. Buy any laptop, score a bonus printer. Buy a two-in-one or all-in-one desktop computer, grab a bonus copy of Microsoft Office. Buy any desktop PC, you'll get a bonus monitor. Huge bonuses on a huge range of computers. Better be quick, Darwin, while it lasts. Joyce Main, computer bonus bonanza.
Joyce Main.
Auto Trend Winelli. We are the commercial specialists. We've always got a massive range of late model Toyota, of 4x4 wagon, work utes, buses, vans, troopies and light trucks. All workshop tested and ready for the territory. We have an easy access website which is always up to date. We can organise delivery of vehicles to you in any location across the NT and Australia. People can rely on our cars and can rely on us. Thinking late model, thinking commercial, think Auto Trend Winelli.
Are you looking to sell or exit your business? Explore your exit options for the best outcome and maximise your return. Specialist business advisory tailored for owners. Call Andrew Hahn at Territory Business Sales to discuss your exit options today.
The Beds R Us Hot Summer Sale is on. Get up to a massive 50% off our Australian-made Sleepyhead and Sleepmaker mattresses. Beds, bedroom furniture and Manchester. Hot Summer Sale. On now at your locally owned Beds R Us store.
Britain is waking up to Brexit. In just 16 hours, the UK will officially leave the EU. Europe correspondent Sophie Walsh is in London, and Sophie, I imagine a big day of fanfares planned.
Celebrations have already begun, kicking off in Brussels, the heart of the EU. In terms of immediate change, don't expect much. It will be business as usual for trade and travel until the end of the year, while that 11-month transition period takes place. Later on tonight, we will hear from UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson. He's expected to say, this is not an end, but a beginning. This is the dawn of a new era in which we no longer accept that your life chances should depend on which part of the country you grow up in. This is the moment when we begin to unite and level up. 3 years, 7 months after that referendum, the front page is saying it all here this morning. Our time has come. 11 p.m. tonight, the UK will leave the EU for good. Sam?
Yes, very exciting. Thanks for that, Sophie. Well, this is the damage done to a police vehicle after it was rammed by a stolen Commodore south of Sydney. The driver was arrested and today refused bail. One of his passengers was also released, but police are still searching for a third man who was in the back seat.
The ACT is in a state of emergency tonight, facing the worst bushfire threat since the devastating fires of 2003. A monster fire front's closing in on Canberra, propelled by a dangerous mix of extreme heat, wind and dry land.
A trusted weapon in a fresh battle.
bombing run on a fire emergency, bringing back nightmares for the people of Canberra.
The ACT is now facing the worst bushfire threat since the devastating fires of 2003.
Back then, four people died and more than 470 homes were destroyed or severely damaged.
What are the 10 things that contribute to having a really, really, really dangerous fire? They are lining up.
40-plus degree temperatures, strong winds pushing towards Canberra's southern suburbs, prompting a state of emergency for the first time in 17 years.
It is a bit scary, but because you've been through it before, you sort of know what to expect.
And the authorities have also learned from the past, with rural communities in the line of fire given plenty of warning.
We're ready to go if we need to.
It's a waiting game which will drag on over the weekend, with tomorrow expected to be even hotter and the winds even stronger.
Waiting and waiting and waiting. Can't wait for it till it's over. Sick of waiting.
A torture which is clearly taking its toll.
Been living out here, so yeah, that's... Sorry. Gets tired, you know.
Ruth Wynne Williams, Nine News.
Optus is facing more than $500,000 in fines after breaching Australian spam laws. The company sent text messages and marketing emails to consumers who'd unsubscribed on more than 2 million occasions.
A $1,000 fine and 4 demerit points. That's the penalty you're facing from midnight tonight if you get busted using your phone while driving. And if this new police body cam is anything to go by, plenty of drivers will be caught.
So you're not going to always tell someone using a phone at the lights, it's when everyone else goes and they're still parked.
The easy thing to do is to put that phone in a place where you cannot access it or where it will not distract you. And we will all be safer on the roads if we do that.
The fine will also apply to motorbike riders and cyclists. Murph's in with sport now. And Murph, is it the end of an era for the Fed Express?
Paul, there's been plenty of speculation. Roger clears the air, that's next. Plus, Kevin Walters' origin future unclear in the countdown to the 2020 series. Plus, why the Bullets must fire in their NBL clash with Melbourne United.
We never stop asking tough questions.
Why don't you walk? Look at what it's doing to you.
I'm uncomfortable asking you.
We never stop chasing the story.
Cardinal Pell, what made you decide to blow the whistle?
We never stop fighting for you.
If anybody deserves it, mate, you do.
How happy are you guys when you see the rain?
Thank you so much.
We never stop.
A Current Affair on Nine.
At Coles, we're helping to lower the cost of summer favourites. Coles Thin Beef Barbecue Sausages, down to just $9 a pack. Coles, good things, great value.
It's gonna be a long drive, mate. A certain kind of life.
Not yet, mate. You don't know
what it's like. Back to sleep, baby. You don't know what it's like. Yeah, Lou, this is the one. To love somebody. Ruby! To love somebody. One's excited to see that.
To lower the cost of lunchboxes. Coles Bakery High Fibre Low GI Bread. Just $3 every day. Coles. Good things, great value.
Want to know where to go? Pick up a free Outback Exposure map. It'll tell you where to go, how to get there, what to do and see, where to eat, and even where to swim. The Outback Exposure map tells you where to go. So get going.
It's Murray Oakley Discount Electrical Retrovision's half-yearly clearance with savings you won't want to miss. Save on all the big brands across entertainment, kitchen, laundry, tech, cleaning, and more. The half-yearly clearance on now at Murray Oakley Discount Electrical Retrovision.
At Coles, we're helping to lower the cost of summer favourites. Coles Barbecue Pack. Down to just $9 for a 1 kilo pack. Coles. Good things, great value.
Superstar Naomi Watts presents
an extraordinary new series.
Tooronga starts Feb 8 on 9.
This weather alert brought to you by Fridgelink, your Daikin air conditioning specialists.
Dominic Thiem and Alexander Zverev will battle it out at Melbourne Park tonight for a chance to meet Novak Djokovic in Sunday's final. While Roger Federer is quietly confident he'll be back next year, quashing any talk of retirement.
A standing ovation as a dejected Roger Federer left Rod Laver Arena, with many of the belief it may have been the last time.
Today was horrible, you know, to go through what I did. Nice entrance, nice send-off, and in between, it's one to forget.
Despite his fitness battles, the 38-year-old fronted up to take on a red-hot Novak Djokovic.
Oh, wow.
Admitting the odds were always against him.
You know you have a 3% chance to win, and, you know, kind of go for it. You never know, but once you can see it coming that it's not going to work anymore, it's tough.
But he's vowed to swiftly iron out his latest groin and back complaints with every intention to return to Melbourne Park for another crack at a seventh title.
You never know how what the future holds, but especially my age, you don't know. But I'm confident. I'm happy how I'm feeling, to be honest. I got through a good, nice training block. No plans to retire, so from that standpoint, we'll see how the year goes.
And more Aussie heartbreak in the mixed doubles, with Astra Sharma and JP Smith falling short in the semi-final.
But experience wins the day. Matt Exams and Murray through to the Australian Open final.
Corey Norris, Nine News.
Kevin Walters is a step closer to increasing his tenure as Maroons coach. The 52-year-old formally applied for a contract extension at today's QRL board meeting. Walters won his first two series as coach, but has lost his past two. The board's expected to make a decision on his future before April. The elimination of the Hobart Hurricanes means there's only four teams left in contention in the Big Bash final series. But the Sydney Thunder were accused of not playing within the spirit of the game after having an extra player outside the fielding restriction circle during their win over Hobart. Playoff atmosphere arrives early in Brisbane tomorrow when the Bullets host Melbourne United in the NBL. The result will go a long way to deciding who features in the finals, with the sides occupying fourth and fifth spot on the ladder. The Reds Super Rugby season opener against the Brumbies is going ahead tonight, despite smoke haze still blanketing Canberra. Officials have declared the stadium safe to play. The Reds will also have to deal with 38-degree heat in the nation's capital. Southern Districts are aiming to get their NTFL season back on track after a string of defeats. A win over Wanderers tomorrow night will keep the Crocs in the running for finals.
They've suffered successive losses since the Christmas break, but Southern Districts insist it hasn't broken their stride.
Obviously, four in a row, it can, you know, take its toll. We're actually looking forward as the challenge.
The Crocs made it all the way to the grand final last year, but went down to Nightcliffe. Going into round 16, they've now slumped to fifth place on the ladder. And with just three games left before finals, it's time to knuckle down if they want a shot at the flag again.
You know, we've got blokes that are battling with injuries and we've got other blokes that aren't available, and I think we can, you know, just do what we got with who rocks up.
This week they're up against Wanderers.
Wanderers are a very good side. All their young players are starting to step up. Bo O'Connell, Joel Jeffrey and a couple of others.
But luckily for the Crocs, they'll be bolstered by the return of one of their most dangerous defenders.
Ed Barlow's a 40 disposal player, you know, so having him around really boosts our confidence and just gets the boys up and about.
Ellie Conway, Nine News.
The National Indigenous Cricket Championships are as much about inclusiveness as they are First Nations culture. And a South Australian player is a prime example that anyone can play the sport they love.
Like all cricketers in Alice Springs this week, Luke Trudgett has a passion for the sport. Originally from Sydney, he moved to Adelaide 4 years ago. He's currently South Australia's most decorated deaf cricketer.
Very proud to be here in Alice Springs to play Indigenous cricket, and it's a great opportunity for me and a really good standard of cricket.
Luke has played at an elite level representing both states, but it hasn't hampered the ability to communicate with his team. And one upside would be he wouldn't be impacted by any sledging.
The players are really lovely. You know, they're very welcoming. They're very friendly. You know, they try to be gesturing and, good humour, and they've been wonderful.
As well as celebrating his culture, Luke's focus is getting the win for South Australia.
We're hoping to get in the finals first and foremost. So we've made grand final 3 years in a row. And, you know, hopefully for South Australia boys, we can get in the four and hopefully go on and win the cup.
Kathleen Gazzola, Nine News.
Yeah, what a great story. That's what sport is all about. And that is a wrap of sport for tonight. Don't go anywhere, though. Sophie Ryan will be here next. She'll take a check of your weather as we head into the weekend.
In your Big Bad Wednesday Night drama, the devil is coming out to play. New Doctor Doctor starts Wednesday after Married.
Your new home. The time to build your new home is now. The Build Bonus Grant of $20,000 is here to help Territorians building a new home in the Territory. Grants are limited. Learn more at buildbonus.nt.gov.au.
Darwin Golf Club in Morara are now ready to bring you an even better club, a family-friendly club, a place to relax and enjoy the vibrant sports atmosphere. Try our exciting new lunch and dinner menu as the sun sets over the range. And DGC staff, always happy to help. Sports on the screens, live entertainment Fridays, enjoy dinner Wednesday to Sunday and a welcoming community feel. We highly recommend you take a slice of the new Darwin Golf Club atmosphere just off McMillan's Road in Morara.
Milkwood Steiner School, educating students from kindergarten to year 7. At Milkwood, we cherish childhood and educate for excellence, inspiring students to excel academically and personally. Milkwood Steiner School delivers the nationally accredited Steiner curriculum. This curriculum works in harmony with natural human development to produce the best results in the long term. Milkwood Steiner School, educating the whole child, head, heart, and hands.
Have a good one, mate. Oh, and have you told Tim he's not invited to your wedding?
Okay, bye.
What? Wedding?
I don't want you to take this personally, but, you know, my sister's going to be there. I know you didn't mean to spill Nan's ashes into the pool, mate. Mum was cleaning out that pool filter for weeks.
Really?
Granddad's terrified of the pool now, so it's probably best you sit this one out.
That makes total sense.
Good on you, mate.
Handle any situation in a Ranger FX4.
Not your first home? That's okay. The Build Bonus Grant of $20,000 is available to Territorians regardless of prior ownership. Eligibility criteria applies. Grants are limited. Learn more at buildbonus.nt.gov.au.
This sports report brought to you by Harvey Norman, serving the Territory for 20 years. Shop online or in store.
Good evening, everyone. Sophie Ryan here with your weather report. It was another scorcher. We only dipped to 29 degrees overnight. The maximum in the city was 33, a touch above average. On the chart, a trough extends across the southern and central districts of the NT, while a warm and humid westerly flow continues over the NT north of that trough. Meanwhile, another trough approaching from WA will move through the south on the weekend, bringing continued showers and storms and a cool change to southern districts. Now, most top-enders will welcome monsoon-like conditions next week, and we could see a tropical low form within it, most likely near the southwest top end. If it does, we may see some heavy rain with storms in the Darwin area from Monday. Heading across the country for your Saturday, a scorcher down south, heatwave conditions continuing there for Canberra, 41 on the way tomorrow. Some storms for Adelaide and Melbourne, showers in Hobart, 27. Warming up in Perth, 29 the top under sunny skies. Temperatures for the Territory tomorrow, 34 degrees for Palmerston and Howard Springs, 35 for Katherine. Heading further south, stormy conditions, 33 on the way for Tennant Creek, cooler for Alice Springs, 35 for Yallara. Offshore westerly winds up to 15 knots. The season swell we have around 1 metre there for the seas. Our low tide just before 4 in the afternoon. High tide 10:22 around 5.7 metres. On to today's catch of the day winner. It's Kayla with her 87 centimetre barramundi caught out at Shady Camp. Congratulations, Kayla. Awesome catch you have there. Moving on now to the outlook for Palmerston. The medium chance of showers, storms possible, dipping to 26 overnight. Sunrise 6:39, 7:20 for the sunset. And we have the rural area heading for a top of 34, and of course for Darwin, 33 degrees, stormy and the medium chance of showers. And we'll take a look ahead for the next 7 days now. So we have showery and stormy conditions continuing right through well into next week. And those are your full weather details. Good night.
Thanks, Sophie. Well, Prince Harry lost his complaint against a UK newspaper over a photo he posted on Instagram. The tabloid ran an uncropped version of the picture showing a rope around the elephant's leg, claiming Harry didn't tell the whole story. Prince Harry argued the paper's report was inaccurate, but his claim was rejected.
Somebody's pulling someone's leg.
That's Nine News for this Friday.
Thanks for joining us from all the team. Good night.
Good night. Have a good week.